how do I find the angle measure from sine theta equals 1/2? And we are going to solve this in degrees from 0 to 90 degrees and also in radians from 0 to pi over 2. So now let's take a look. We have sine theta equals 1/2. And whenever we are trying to solve this kind of equations, if the question is asking you to not use a calculator, then we must remember the following two special right triangles. The first one is the 45-45-90 special right triangle. 45 degrees here and then 45 degrees here. And the ratio of the sides are 1-1 because they are the same. And then the hypotenuse is square root of 2. And the other special right triangle is the following. The 30-60-90 special right triangle looks something like this. Here, it's the bigger angle because that's away from the longer side. Not the longest though, longer side. So this right here is 60 degrees. This right here is 30 degrees. Now, the ratio of the sides are, the shortest side is 1, the longer side is square root of 3. And the longest side, the hypotenuse, the longest, is 2. Be careful though, 2 is bigger than square root of 3. Make sure you remember the ratio of the sides. And then if you would like, I can make another video showing why this is the case, but that will be later on. So now if you take a look at this equation, sine theta equals 1 over 2. Because the angle theta is just between 0 to 90 degrees, so we can just look at this angle as an acute angle. Later on, you will have to be dealing with the angle that's bigger than 90 degrees, but that will be later on. Based on this right here, just remember, what's the definition of sine in a right triangle? The answer is opposite over adjacent. So here is the opposite, and then here's the opposite over hypotenuse. Ready? Opposite over hypotenuse. Based on this, we can go ahead and construct a right triangle. Have a look. Let's say this right here is 1, and then hypotenuse is like this. Let's say this right here is 2. That's a 2. And then, let me just, oh man. This right here is 2. Right, so 1, 2, and then, yeah. What's this side though? 1, 2, and this side will be square root of 3. Okay, so this right here is square root of 3. So based on 1 and 2, right, you can figure out that this right here has to be square root of 3. And our goal is to figure out what this angle is. Well, this angle is away from 1. The angle away from 1 is 30 degrees. So this angle has to be 30 degrees. That angle right there is 60, but we don't care. Sine of 30 degrees is opposite over hypotenuse. So 1 over 2. So as you can see, theta equals 30 degrees. So that's the first part. And in fact, that's the only answer on this interval. Now, we will also have to give the radian answer for this. And this is how we are going to do it. When we have degree measure, we are going to multiply this by what? Pi radian over 180 degrees. And I would recommend you to work with degrees first and then just change it to radians. It's easier that way. Now you see, the reason I put pi over 180 degrees is because degree cancel. And then here we have, this is 30 pi over 180 radian. And you can just reduce. 30 goes into 30 one time, and 30 goes into 180 six times. So this right here will be for the radian, and altogether, 1 pi is just pi over 6. So pi over 6 radian. Okay. So yeah, that's our theta as well. Again, 30 degrees, pi over 6. And if you need more help with this kind of trigonometric equations, make sure you subscribe, and then later I will do more videos for this right here for you. Because I know this kind of right here, this kind of equations can be pretty tricky, and they are not easy. But anyway though, best of luck in your trig or pre-calculus class. That's it.